There's a song that's inside of my soul. It's the one that I've tried to write over and over again. I'm awake in the infinite cold, but you sing to me over and over and over again. So I lay my head back down and I
beautiful, Emily.
Thanks.
Big deal.
Nervous. Excited. I just want to see him. So I bid mine goodbye and never knew. So close. Waiting here with you. Is he nervous? He is. That makes me happy.
So close, so close to reaching that famous happy end. Almost believing this one's not pretending. Now you're beside me, and look how far we've come. So far.
Was nice, the party was pumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a pool with shout out.
Ladies, leave your man at home. The club is full of ballers and their pockets full grown. And now you fellas leave your girl with her friends. Cause it's 11:30 and the club is jumping, jumping. We say you got a girl, and yeah, it's true, you got a man. And you stayed at home alone and lonely. Couldn't find your man, he was chilling with his homies. This week and you're going out. If they try to stop you, you're going off. You got your hair done and your nails done too. I'll wait and you finish your shoes. You and your group are laying at the hottest spot tonight. You're going find the fellas rolling in the Lexus trucks and Hummers.
So we say you got a girl, yeah, it's true, you got a man. But the party ain't gonna stop, so let's make it high.
Ladies, leave your man at home. The club is full of ballers and their pockets full of bums.
You may be seated.
Friends and family, welcome and thank you for sharing in this very special and momentous occasion. But before we begin, please join me in a moment of silence for the ones who could not be here in body, but surely here with us in spirit. Please bow your heads.
Thank you.
We have been invited here today to share with Jake and Emily a very important moment in their lives. In the years they've been together, their love and understanding of each other has grown and matured, and now they have decided to live their lives together as husband and wife. Who here gives this woman to be this man's bride?
Her mother.
Marriage is a promise made in the hearts of two people who love each other, which takes a lifetime to fulfill. Within the circle of its love, marriage encompasses all of life's most important relationships. A wife and husband are each other's lover, teacher, listener, critic, and most importantly, best friend. According to Greek mythology, fun fact, humans were originally created with four arms, four legs, a head, and two faces. Fearing that their power, Zeus split them into two separate parts, condemning them to spend their lives in search of each other's halves. I think we can all agree, Jake and Emily have found each other's other half. Jake, do you take Emily to be your wife? Do you promise to continue making her smile on a regular basis? To always kill spiders? And buy her ice cream when needed? Do you promise to always go along with her on random adventures around town? And most importantly, do you promise to keep loving her like you have for the last 1,124 days? Emily, do you take Jake to be your husband? Do you promise to never laugh when he shows you how much of a nerd he really is? To always be willing to learn a new game of his choosing? Do you promise to always track down a 120-minute dogfish head whenever possible? And as well, do you promise to keep loving him like you have for the last 1,124 days?
I do.
Presentation of the rings. The ring is a symbol of unity, in which your two lives are now joined in an unbroken circle, in which wherever you go, you will return to one another. Jake, take your left hand, and as you place the ring on her finger, please repeat after me.
With this ring,
I give you my heart. I promise that from this day forward, you shall not walk alone. May my heart be your shelter, and may my arms be your home. Emily, take his left hand. And as you place the ring on his finger, repeat after me. With this ring, I give you my heart.
I
promise that from this day forward. You shall not walk alone. May my heart be your shelter. And may my arms be your home. May you always feel as close as you do this day, right now, in this moment, in front of all your friends and family, loved ones. May your lives be graced with good health. May you always find happiness in your home. And may it be a refuge from the storms of life. May your love grow ever stronger as you share your lives together. And may your future be even more wonderful than you ever dreamed possible. May your promise to share each other's hopes, thoughts, and dreams as you build your lives together. May your lives be ever intertwined, your love keeping you together forever and always. May you build a home that is compassionate to all, full of respect and honor for others and each other. May your home be forever filled with peace, happiness, and love. Jake and Emily, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Friends and family, I have the greatest honor to introduce you for the first time. This is Jake and Emily Zetterberg.
And our parents of the groom, Mr. and Mrs. Bob and Sandy Zetterberg.
Yeah.
would you please rise? Join me in honoring, for the very first time, the new Mr. and Mrs. Jake and Emily Zetterberg. Could please take their seats and keep their attention on our dance floor for our bride and groom's first dance as Mr. and Mrs. Zetterberg. Let's give them another round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
If you were falling, then I would catch you. You need a light, I'd find a match, 'cause I always say good morning, and you take me the way I am. If you are chilly,
and at this time, our father, the bride, would like to say a few words.
This is the part y'all been looking forward to. How am I doing on time, Chris? All right, okay. Don't they look beautiful? Let's give it up for the bride's room. I'm responsible for the bride. And you're off the insurance. I said you're off the insurance.
Oh, okay.
You're his problem now. Well, they're going to give you a little few minutes here to talk, so I'll make it short, because those of you who don't know me, I'm Jeff Burton, I'm Emily's dad. Those of you who do know me know I like to hear my own voice. So I'm just going to say a couple words. Emily, of course, I've known for 26 years. 26, right?
Yeah.
How long have we been married, Chris?
25.
25 years, okay. Yeah, 26. And as you can see, you know, if you look at table four over here, you'll see the little curly-haired girl. That's the one I remember. I don't know who this beautiful woman is back here. I think that's Chris's responsibility. It certainly isn't mine. Hopefully she got some of Chris and not very much of me. Jake, I've only known for a couple of years. Apparently, he stalked my daughter for 2 years before I met him. And when he finally came around the house and we started to get to know him, we found out that he was really a nice guy. I blame Bob and Sandy for that. Because I'm pretty sure that it wasn't my fault and it wasn't Chris's fault. They've done a fabulous job. Yes, you can applaud. Go ahead. And as you can probably tell, I am not prepared whatsoever. I've only known about this for about a year and a half. So I thought I'd just come and not know anything. But that being said, you know, Jake, we found out that he was actually going to be part of the family, and he actually was going to embrace us and take us into his family when he gave my wife a two-armed hug last night. And if anybody knows Jake, he doesn't even hug his family with two arms. But he hugged my wife. We're going to have a talk later. That being said, I'm done talking. Everybody raise your glasses. Let's toast the newly married Mr. and Mrs. Jake Zetterberg. That was under 5 minutes, right?
Of honor, and I've known Emily for 10 years. I spent a lot of time with Emily today, and since she is the centerpiece, I would like to address Jake. Dear Jake, remember that time Zach and Carl thought we were on a date? And then you showed them the engagement ring you had bought for Emily. That was awesome. We had gone out only to find that the ring store was not open yet. So we had a very nervous and happy breakfast and looked at all the rings. After a while, the lady at the counter, who I'm sure was sick of us, pulled out a ring. And instantly, you knew it was the one. Your eyes got so wide, and all you said was, "It's so shiny!" In the store, literally, that's what he said. At that moment, I knew it was real. You got it. That is exactly what Emily would have said. It's these little things, the understanding, that makes the two of you fit so well together. Plus, you're honest with each other. Who else is going to tell you how very, very gross you are after you rip a big one as you walk across the living room? Emily, that too. That's nice. What a lucky man you are. It's true, though. Emily is entertaining. She looks damn good in a wedding dress. And I think she loves you, too. Plus, you get to be part of an awesome family. As you and Em embark on this grand adventure together, remember, her dad is a big, very scary dude. And enjoy the little special moments you get together. I love you both. You'll have beautiful babies. And congratulations.
Battery.
Let's give her a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. And last but not least, our best man, Zach Britton.
All right. Well, as you said, for those of you who don't know me, I'm Zach Britton, and I've been best friends with Jake since third grade when he came into MBCA. And the only thing I can remember is we did everything together. We played sports, hung out in the basement being nerds, playing Guitar Hero, going on vacations together, hanging out in the pool. We even went to college together, but for the past 15 years that I've known Jake, I've never seen him happier than he has been since Emily came along, and she's fantastic. I love hanging out with Emily. She's wonderful. But sorry, I'm nervous. I don't like speaking. But, yeah, like I said, I've never seen them happier, and these two are perfect for each other. And watching them, they've found something that seems harder and harder to find these days. And I know they're going to have a wonderful future. I'm going to be excited to be there, watch it, and be a part of it. Cheers, guys.
Let's give them another round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Now, if we could all turn our attention over to our cake.
Okay, go ahead. Ready? Cut. Beautiful, Emily.
Thanks.
How do you feel?
Nervous. Excited. I just want to see him. So I bid mine goodbye and never knew. So close. Waiting here with you. Is he nervous? He is. That makes me happy.
All that I wanted. is to hold you so close, so close to reaching that famous happy.
Without further ado, that was a great way to open the dance floor. Our dance floor is now open. Please enjoy.
Harlem Shake.
First things first, I'm the realest, realest. Drop this and let the whole world feel it.
Let them feel it.
And I'm still in the murder business. I can hold you down like I'm giving lessons in physics.
Right, right.
You want a bad bitch like this,
huh?
Drop it low and pick it up just like this.
Yeah.
Cup of Ace, cup of Goose, cup of Chris. I heal something worth a half a ticket on my wrist.
I'm so fancy.
Somebody help me! Jump in the line, rock your body in time.
Yeah. the night. Thank you.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray.
Congratulations! Love you!
Right through the very heart.
I love you, Jake and Emily. I love you. I love you.
Peace. I'm melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it. In old New York.
Bye. If
I can.
Love you guys, Jake and Emily.
I turned into Mohawk Mike.
Emily, Jake, I love you guys. I hope you enjoy our gift. It's an amazing time.
New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that never sleeps.
We hope you had a blast tonight. Jake and Emily, we wish you nothing but the best. Everybody, please be safe getting home. And with that being said, the last shuttle to